Jay Haynes with the Film Sensei YouTube channel. Today in this video, I'm going to show you how to mimic Adobe After Effects Turbulent Displacement effect in HitFilm. Turbulent displacement in After Effects is a distortion effect that is applied to video footage. Turbulent displacement uses fractal noise mathematical equations to create that displacement. You can create your own turbulent displacement effect in HitFilm by using either the built-in distortion effects or the displacement effect coupled with a fractal noise effect. In this video, I will cover both. HitFilm Pro comes standard with heat, fluid, energy, and smoke distortions. HitFilm Express comes with only the heat distortion standard, but you can buy the others via the VFX distortion pack. Applying one of these effects to a grade layer above the footage or applying it directly to the footage will give you the equivalent of Adobe After Effects turbulent displacement. The mathematical equations are identical. For example, if I drag the heat distortion effect onto a grade layer above the footage, I can adjust these sliders to dial in exactly what I'm looking for. These distortion effects can be found in the Distort folder under the Effects tab. Don't forget that you can mask this effect to only appear exactly where you want it. And you can layer several different distortion effects on top of each other for a more realistic looking turbulence. If you want to create your own turbulent displacement effect, start by creating a composite shot and call it Displacement Map. Add a plane and drag the fractal noise effect onto that plane. The fractal noise effect can be found under the Generate folder in the Effects tab. Adjust the drop-down choices and sliders accordingly. You will want to keyframe the seed property to change over time, and possibly the exposure and offset properties as well. When you have dialed in the fractal noise settings in your displacement map, create a second composite shot and then drag in the displacement map. You won't actually need to see it, so you can go ahead and turn off the visibility of that layer. Place your footage into the new composite shot and add the displacement effect either directly to that footage or to a grade layer above that footage. You can find that effect in the Distort folder with the other distortion effects. Select the displacement map composite layer as the displacement source. Remember that you can mask this out as necessary. Adjusting the max horizontal and vertical displacement sliders will determine how much displacement there will be. You may now also want to tweak the fractal noise settings in the displacement map. You can do this in real time while still being able to see the effect in the final composite shot by using the pin tool. Simply select the fractal noise effect in the displacement map composite shot and click this tool on the top of the control panel to pin it. Then you can go back to the second composite shot and see the results as you adjust the settings of the fractal noise in its own control panel. Like I said before, Adobe After Effects Turbulent Displacement effect, as well as HitFilm's heat, fluid, smoke, and energy distortion effects, use the exact same fractal equations as the fractal noise in this displacement map. In the case of both After Effects Turbulent Displacement and HitFilm's distortion effects, the displacement modifier is built in. Therefore, you never actually see the underlying noise of the effect. I'm Jay Haynes with the Film Sensei YouTube channel. If you have any questions, please feel free to leave them in the comments below. I would be delighted to answer them for you. Also, don't forget to like and subscribe. Until next time, thanks for watching.